Welcome student, we are studying from previous lecture, that is civics lesson, that is the rural local government bodies. So here are three bodies which look after the governance of rural area, that is Gram Panchayat at the village level, Panchayat Samiti at the block level, and the Jilla Parishad. Okay, and in these lessons we look out the office bearer and all these things, and now we are looking for the Panchayat Samiti. Okay, so here are the points. All the villages within a taluka, we need tools. Okay. The Panchayat Samiti, all the all villages within a taluka form a development block. The body that look after the functioning of development blocks is the Panchayat Samiti. It is also act as a link between the Jilla Parishad and Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat is over now the office bearer of the Panchayat Samiti. Here is the picture of Gram Sabha at Gram Panchayat office. Okay, and the peoples themselves put their views and arguments in front of sarpanch. Through this picture we come to know that there is a lady, this central lady is the sarpanch of the village. Am I correct? And other persons who are arguments are the villagers. So these are the dialogues speak out by the people, that finally the Gram Panchayat elections are over. There is so much excitement in the village. Now let us see how the village develops in next 5 years. So this is the other person who is having goggles. Second, so what is Gram Sabha for? We must all be present for the meeting of the Gram Sabha. So the other villagers also put their views. Okay, so next, the office bearer of Panchayat Samiti. Elections to the Panchayat Samiti are held every 5 years. The elected members elect from among themselves. The chairman and deputy chairman are elected . The chairman has a responsibility of calling the meeting and conducting the business of meeting. In the absence of chairman, the deputy chairman presides over the meeting. Next point of the Panchayat Samiti. Here is the half circle which shown us the responsibilities or functions of Panchayat Samiti. The first is need of the public. So the public needed the roads, gutter, well, bore wells, etc. Next is health. Vaccination program must be enact by the panchayat samiti. Today in the corona situation also it is very important that this function of panchayat samiti is very important. And nowadays we heard the message, heard the news of that everyone is setting up a corona centers in our area. A week ago our deputy chief minister Mr. Ajit Pawar inaugurated the corona center in Vaduj, okay, having the full facilities in that center. Water supply, providing the clean drinking water, okay, this is the responsibility of village and panchayat samiti, supply of drinking water. Public hygiene, cleanliness of roads and disposal of waste. In our city Vaduz, every day we saw the ladies who clean the roads. There are 15 to 20 ladies who clean the roads of whole city, okay. In the agriculture, panchayat samiti help the farmers to improve agriculture and livestock. Education, primary education, they set up the responsibilities of the primary education. Next is industries, promotion of handicraft, cottage industry in the panchayat areas, providing financial aids to the weaker section. So it is a welfare. This panchayat samiti work as a welfare of the peoples, okay. The function of panchayat samiti, the panchayat samiti prepares a plan of schemes to be implemented in the development block. It is binding on the panchayat samiti to hold at least one meeting every month. The panchayat samiti receives a certain amount of money from the district fund. It also receives grants from the state government to carry out the development schemes of the development block. So this is the function of panchayat samiti. Next is the Jilla Parishad. Every district has a Jilla Parishad at present. The state of Maharashtra has a 36 district but only 34 Jilla Parishad. The reason is that the Mumbai city district and Mumbai suburban districts do not have rural population. Therefore, they do not have Jilla Parishad. The office bearer of the Jilla Parishad, the elections to the Jilla Parishads are held every 5 years and elected the representative choose the president and vice president from among themselves. The president of the Jilla Parishad presides over the meeting of Jilla Parishad. He exercises control over a business, conducted during the meeting. He also controls the financial transactions of the Jilla Parishad. He has the authority to undertake appropriate expenditures from Jilla Parishad's fund. The Vice President carried out these duties in the absence of the President. So here are the duties of the Jilla Parishad. Here are the pictures, okay, that is the education facility, health facility, water supply, provision of seeds, electricity and the tree plantations in the villages. These are the programs which enact by the Jilla Parishad. Chief Executive Officer CEO. The decision taken by the Jilla Parishads are implemented by the Chief Executive Officer. So this CEO, he is appointed the state government so here is the structure of Jilla Panchayat Raj system, that is President, Jilla Parishad, Chief Executive Officer, Chairman, Panchayat Samiti, Block Development Officer, Sarpanch, Gram Panchayat, Gram Sevak, elected representative and appointed by the government. Okay, local governmental bodies in rural area, it is Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti and Jilla Parishad. The total membership of the Gram Panchayat is minimum 7, maximum 17, minimum 15, maximum 45, minimum 50, maximum 75. Sarpanch, office bearers, Sarpanch, Deputy Sarpanch, Chairman, Deputy Chairman, President, Vice President, Office Officers, Gram Sevak, Block Development Officer and Chief Executive Officer. Okay, this is the structure of Panchayat Raj in the rural area at Gram Panchayat level, at Panchayat Samiti level, at Jilla Parishad level. Okay. So here you have to do the exercise of this lesson. Okay, if you found any difficulty, please send me a message on my personal number. Okay. Now we will stop here.